my name is Belinda Dowston. Welcome to the I Ching Cafe and our first full weekly episode for January, with the week commencing the 3rd of January, 2022. Hot on the heels of the annual overview, the monthly overview, here we are at the first week. So, if you've not yet done so, go check out January. Go and look at what we're being asked to pay attention to as we work with cutting back, keeping things simple, letting go of the old, making a sacrifice to make space, to open ourselves up, to be able to learn new things. So in this first week, what do we have? So last week we had hexagram 63 after completion. The last locked hexagram of December after a whole slew of locked hexagrams in December. And we were asked to pay attention to closure, completion, and endings. Finishing the finishing. So what was closing off for you? Was it just the year, the calendar closing off, or are there other processes being switched off and being completed? I had a huge revelation right in the tail end of last week of an aspect of myself that I was done with, that I was complete with, something I'd done in the past, which I didn't realize I didn't need to do anymore, and I closed it off and I lovingly released it. And so I started the week fresh, creating space, as January has asked us to do. So this week, our first hexagram is hexagram 1, the creative. So last week we had 63, which is after finishing. It's the second last hexagram of the set. And this week we have hexagram 1, the creative, which is the first one in the set. I just think that's amazing. We finished something for realsies. We closed it off last year. In the last week, we closed it off. This week, we are rebooting and we are restarting and coming back to life. And that might literally be for you, like for last week, the calendar year. Or it might be a new beginning is activating for you. So hexagram 1, the creative, is all about the upsurge of creative power. This does not mean doing art, okay? It's about our ability to creatively solve problems, of beginning new cycles, the opportunity of rebirthing ourselves into a new era. It's a powerful hexagram of surging, of action, of power, of energy, of the creative spark flinting into our lives and bringing us a huge boost of energy to start off the new cycle, to start off the year. We couldn't have asked for a better hexagram to start our first weekly than this one. Now there's only one changing line for this week in the second position. And with hexagram 1, the creative, it's all about symbolizing a dragon emerging and soaring, that dragon power starting to uncoil and unleash itself into the heavens. And line 2 is all about the horns of the dragon are just visible over the horizon. In other words, the creative power is no longer inside the earth where it's hidden, it's now emerging. And what we can do is we can lean into it and we can activate it and we can start accessing it and start drawing on it and using it to create blessings. This is about opening up to that flow of creative energy, of being welcoming to it, of connecting with people who can help us, of connecting with others, of surging into it and starting to work with the creative flow that's coming back after this ending cycle we had last week. So that's our changing line. What's our second hexagram? Now, our second hexagram is our flow of change that works in parallel, but it builds up throughout the week. So we start the week full force, the creative, and as we start coming to the second half of the week, we start really leaning into the second hexagram, and that is hexagram 13, fellowship. This is a wonderful hexagram that is all about uniting with others around a shared common goal, where the thing that's important to us is the thing that binds us. And as a leader, how can we work with this hexagram? We can rally people around the common goal. We can build fellowship. This is like the fellowship of the ring, where our joint goal, we want that ring thrown into the flames. We want to destroy it. We want to save the world. And so all this weird raggle-taggle crowd is joining the quest to get rid of this ring. And so fellowship with others is a key part of the week. There's something about the week where we're being asked to reach out, to see our opportunities, to collaborate and co-create with others, and not to compete. Okay, so it's not a competitive environment, it's a collaborative environment. Perhaps if you're still on holiday, there's an opportunity then that the people that you're with, your family, your friends, your loved ones, that fellowship is something that you can lead in your group, where you can unite everyone around the shared purpose. And if you're having some challenges in your group, niggles and conflict, the way through it is to follow the advice of this hexagram, which is to unite everyone on the shared purpose. Get everyone back into what is the thing that binds us together? What is that ring that we are all united around? And let us then rally to do that. So, a week of creative flow, a week of new beginnings as we get back into work with some of us, or get back into new flows of change. Pay attention to your ideas that pop into your mind at this time. They are guiding you towards powerful new forces, wanting to call you forward. And remember, look for the fellowship, look for the community, look for the common group of people who share your view, your value system, and work with others to achieve something meaningful this week. So that's our week. Let's see as we go from week to week, if we get a whole onslaught of locked hexagrams or not, or how it unfolds. But we'll be okay. No matter what hexagram we get or changing line, we are here for each other. I'm here for you. Let's do it. Let's grow. Let's grow up together, and let's give this year horns. Let's really make every day, every week, every month count. Thank you so much. Please like, share, and subscribe. There's interesting things that I'm working on that I'll share with you as the year starts going. In the meantime, though, I'll see you on the socials. Have a wonderful first week of the year, and I look forward to seeing you at our next weekly overview. See you soon.